bit, but first, NBA preseason, LeBron James' first game at the Staples Center did not disappoint. The King goes coast to coast for the dunk.
Oh, LeBron gets the steal here. Man on each wing. Oh, let me show the Lakers fans, just in case the Kobe haters had forgot, I still am the King. I gave myself that nickname for a reason.
If they're going with this color yellow in the jersey, that color yellow should be on the court. More on that in an hour.
Oh, jeez.
Rockets Grizzlies.
I'm trying to look at the ball, please. Now you got me looking at the court.
Chris Paul showing off the vision for the slick assist. Threw the defender's legs to Melo for the three.
Man, they could have used one of those threes for the guy who was playing that spot last year, Trevor Ariza, game 7, 0 for 12 against the Warriors.
Okay, I got my fandom out. I'm pulling for Melo.
There we go.
You know what I'm saying? I mean, I don't like guys to be on that list, best players not to win a championship. Yeah. I mean, I like to be on the list with some other people, but
I think the list shorter.
Hornets, Kemba Walker leading the break finds Miles Bridges for the LEU.
Miles Bridges, your guy. Shout out, Coach Izzo, one of our favorites. This is a team, I think they will be better this year than last year just because of the growth of their young players. I like how they drafted. Kemba's one of the most underrated guys in the league. Go get him,
Coach Izzo, check in with me, man. It's football season. Let's talk about your favorite sport. We know you just coach basketball because they pay you. We know your favorite, your love, is football. Hit me, bro.
All right, moving on to the Pittsburgh Steelers. Their record, 4 games in, the ever-so-popular 1-2-1. Mostly due to a lack of a running game, perhaps some in-house struggles, and one of the worst defenses in the league. But just those things. The Steelers are currently 30th in yards allowed and 26th in points allowed. Say it, Nick.
That ain't great.
Steelers captain Cam Hayward said harsh words for his teammates.
The defense isn't about making plays, it's about doing your job. And that's for everybody out there. It's not just one guy. I don't give a damn if I can never get a sack again. But if everybody else does their job and we get off the field, so be it. The same mistakes have happened throughout the year. And if we don't grow and we don't move on and put ourselves in better position, then we're not going to be a successful team. I don't look for big speeches. I just look for production. I look for guys to step up. You know, the kitchen's hot right now, and, you know, everybody's looking to get out, you know, so we got to get to work, and we got to settle it down. Either buy in or don't get on the field.
All right, CC, what do you think? Can the Steelers contend if they don't fix what's going on defense right now?
No, just to let you know who Cam Hayward is, he's one of the great leaders that the Pittsburgh Steelers have, a guy who doesn't say anything. So it's one of those kind of things that, oh, the quiet guy's talking? Like, they should listen to him. So what he's saying is great information. Pittsburgh is not necessarily an attack defense. It's kind of a read and then react defense. So it's very, very important, a lot like New England, that you know your assignments. The reason why Miami last week against New England could not get outside and couldn't run all their speed sweeps and use all their speed is because New England are very assignment conscious, even though they might not be as talented. But from an assignment standpoint, that's who the Pittsburgh Steelers are supposed to be. From a gap control standpoint, they're a two gap. Hold your gap, know your responsibility, and depend on your teammate to be able to know their assignment. So that's what he's saying, that the coaches are doing a good job of teaching us what we're supposed to do, but sometimes guys think that they know more and they want to freelance within the system. So what he's telling us in watching the film, you can see a lot of Pittsburgh Steelers that are freelancing compared to buying into what the game plan is and doing what the coaches tell you to do. You would think in pro sports, is that a normal thing? No, it's not normal. That's why he's speaking out, and that's why I believe that the Pittsburgh Steelers, over the last several years, people talk about Ryan Shazier, his injury and everything, how this defense has been bad since then. Yeah, but it's not John Bostic's fault. Pro Football Focus has him as the middle linebacker, the 10th best middle linebacker in football. So it's not his fault. So we can kind of move on from that narrative. It's this whole defense. It's the front line. It's the linebackers in coverage. It's also that secondary, missed assignments and giving up big plays. So Cam gave us, he enlightened us on what's going on in Pittsburgh. And this is one of those kind of things that He wasn't talking to the fans and everything. He's talking to the locker room. And that's sometimes how you have to utilize the media, because he knows his teammates are listening, and I hope that they heed his words.
So what has happened to the Steelers' defense? The back end right now is giving them where the majority of their trouble is coming. Yes, they have not overcome the Shazier injury, and the numbers are jarring pre-Shazier injury and post, but they had an offseason to fix it.
Yeah.
And you mentioned that Bostic and even Vince Williams hadn't been a terrible player. He's the other inside backer.
Mm-hmm.
The Steelers have made this defense by drafting high-quality players at the top of the draft. Their stars on offense are not first-round picks, aside from Big Ben, who's first-round pick 15 years ago. Le'Veon Bell, Antonio Brown, their wide receivers, not first-round picks. They've spent those first-round and second-round picks on defense, and right now it looks like they've missed on some guys. Artie Burns is a corner that is struggling. They drafted a safety in the first round this year, Terrell Edmonds. It's way too early to say he's a good or a bad pick, but as a rookie safety, he's struggling. They let Mike Mitchell walk out the door. They brought in Morgan Burnett. He's struggling. So, like, the back end of their defense, Joe Hayden is looking older as opposed to how he looked last year when they brought him over from Cleveland. The reason that I think, Jenna, they still can contend is every team in the AFC that we look at as a contender right now has one glaring weakness.
Yes.
The Chiefs have the same weaknesses defensively. I think the Chiefs have a more explosive offense, but when Le'Veon Bell gets back, the Steelers might have a more balanced offense, but they have the same issues defensively. Jacksonville has all these issues in reverse. There's no questions about their defense, all the questions about their offense.
Yes.
The Patriots, to me, there's not one glaring thing I point to, just an overall lack of team speed and lack of elite playmakers on both sides of the ball make it to me where, aside from Tom Brady, what do they do great? So there's no team in the AFC that I'm like, oh, they are a team that is buttoned up across the board, the way Philly was last year, the way I thought Minnesota was last year, the way the Rams appear to be this year. Like, so I think they can overcome it because there's not a team in the conference that doesn't have a similar issue, just maybe on a different side of the ball.
We talk about Ryan Shazier a lot, and yes, you miss his physical productivity, mm-hmm. but is there also something to missing him calling out plays, him being the leader of that defense, him making sure everyone is where they are? You talk about an attack defense and a read and react defense.
Mm-hmm.
Did it change at all when he came out, and is that why?
It did change because, I mean, he's one of the great linebackers. Last year he was having a potential defensive MVP type of season. So even though we might replace some of the productivity from a tackle standpoint, you can't replace two things that I feel like they're missing. His ability to be able to cover tight ends and running backs. I mean, he is a fast guy. He can play sideline to sideline. Bostic is a more physical guy and more in a phone booth type. So Ryan Shazier is one of the elite linebackers, three-down linebackers that we have. And also, man, him and Cam Hayward, they played at Ohio State together. He's one of the great leaders. He was a captain at Ohio State. And I'm not just saying that kid came from Ohio State. I know the kid since he was in high school, when he was in Fort Lauderdale, and he decided to come to Ohio State. He's always been a captain. He's always been an outspoken leader. That part right there is missing from that team.
And you can see the numbers. And again, it's not an excuse. It's an explanation. That since 2017, pre-injury and post-injury, everyone's going to point to the points per game, 17 to 27. But that red zone percentage is jarring. To only give up a touchdown on half of your red zone possessions, now it's 70%, which is third worst in the NFL over that stretch. That final layer leaves that first layer, the points being what they are. And they should be able to overcome one injury. I understand that part of it, but right now they haven't, and the secondary is not helping them. And I would argue not having a running game this part of the season has hurt them, because while they're scoring, they are not maintaining time of possession the way they were last year with Le'Veon Bell, and so the defense is out there more.
They got their work cut out for them this week. They're playing the Atlanta Falcons. How do you fix this defense, and is this something that can be done week to week?
Yeah, it's something that can be done, and it's no different than what I would advise for Belichick. It was no different than what I advised for Tony Dungy when both of these guys had defenses that were struggling. Hey, man, get more involved. This is how you made your money. as a defensive assistant, as a defensive coordinator, you cut your teeth by being an assignment, you know, attack-type defense, design something and get more involved in the room on a daily basis. I believe that's what Mike Tomlin's got to do. That's what Tony Dungy used to do. And we see Belichick all the time. When that defense starts to struggle, you start seeing him more involved in the communication. So when that head coach is a defensive coach, I need him to get involved in what they're doing.
Take full advantage of it. All right, guys, thanks. We got to take a break. Coming up, will Lakers fans embrace LeBron James? That's next up. First things first, we're talking LeBron.
They better.
I'm always for being polite.
When I think
who
you,
are you thinking
I have
of?
No idea. As I said it.
All right, guys,
let's move on.
Rotating two new people.
When we come-